Hello, friends. How are you doing? I hope you're doing well. I genuinely mean that. I hope you're doing well. Let me know if you aren't. I'd love to hear about your issues. I'm Erik, and today we are watching episode 3 of season 4 of Stranger Things. I'm really looking forward to this. I'm really looking forward to seeing where this goes next. It's been just being set up really well, and I just love the vibe of this show, you know? Like the 80s with like government conspiracies and Cold War stuff, like with Russian spies, and there's like the 80s vibe, of course, yeah, and like the monsters and like losers clubs and so on, and like it's just so much nostalgia and so much. I'd love the tropes, and yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing what comes next. Let's see, last time around was really satisfying. Some parts of it, at least. L, aka LL Cool J, aka 11, aka Jane, she showed her bully what for. That was really satisfying. But at the same time, I'm a bit concerned. Because, like, there's two things might happen here. Like, one, she might get in trouble with like the school or like law enforcement. Like, she might get in trouble, and we definitely don't want issues with law enforcement, because like you know, the secret government facility where she was being like held captive and experimented on, like raised, we don't want like anyone to know that she exists, basically. And there's also might be issues with the bullies themselves. Like, I hope that the bullies were like gonna just stay the heck away from her, but they might get really upset and try to teach her a lesson or something, and like really come back down on her. So we'll see. What else? Let's see. Joyce is working on getting Hopper out, and I hope that's gonna go well. It must, right? Maybe it'll take the entire season, though. I don't know. Nancy's her like reporter friend got messed up by Vecna last time. That was... Vecna is very interesting to me. It's very threatening. I like... Like, I'm a big fan of Eldritch horror and cosmic horror, and Vecna feels very unknowable. Like, what are you, and why are you doing this? Like, what's your goal, and how are you able to do it? And like, there's so many questions, and I don't think we're going to get a lot of them answered, but it would be really cool if we did get some answers. Anyways, yeah, let's dive in. I'm curious to see how it's gonna go for Dustin and his friends, now that we have a new ally. I hope he's gonna be an ally, at least. Before we start, though, I just quickly want to shout out the Patreon. Link is in the description down below. On the Patreon, you can get this early access and uncut, and like, I'm a week or two ahead, so like, at this point there should also be like episode 4 should be up there. Yeah, links in the description down below. Check it out if you're interested. There's also all the other shows and movies and stuff I do over there. With that, however, it's time to get into episode 3 of season 4 of Stranger Things. Oh, really? Are we adding... No, that's a helicopter. Okay. I was a little curious. I was thinking, like, are we adding aliens to the mix all of a sudden? But no, it was a helicopter. You could just see the rotor through the window.
No bruises, no signs of any struggle.
Is this guy an expert? Does this guy know
a ghost?
Something about unnatural stuff?
I like your opinion.
I was fired, in case you forgot.
A foreign government invaded our country, all under your watch.
Was this guy from the previous season? I don't remember that season very well at all, because it's a long time since I watched it.
Because as men of science, men like you who created this problem in the first place, everything.
Did they really?
Hawkins can be traced back to Brenner's little pet.
Yeah. And she's drawing attention, unfortunately.
Dr. Brenner trained her for this very thing. Remote assassinations.
Indeed.
What you're suggesting is impossible.
Is it?
Eleven is dead.
I'm not convinced.
No, she's very much not dead, but this is not Eleven. Oh. Is this actually Eleven? But it's Eleven's powers. It's like Vecna was inside Eleven all along, and that's where she got her powers. Maybe? And now Vecna's loose and just like lashing out at things.
Sam, do something!
You gonna come along? No, okay. Doesn't that theory feel like it tracks, you know? Because humans are not supposed to be able to do the stuff that Eleven was doing. The downside to that, is, of course, is that Eleven can't get her powers back in that case. She can't be allowed to be used by this monster. Or to make a pact with a demon, essentially. Like, I don't know. Okay, here we go. Chapter 3.
Can you tell me your name?
Okay, we're catching up right back here. Nice.
You know where you are, Angela.
Ringomania?
This is not good. I mean, it kind of is good. She needed to be put in her place. That sounds wrong put that way, but like she needed to be taught a lesson that she can't just bully people ruthlessly like that and expect there not to be any consequences for it. Yeah, I see you, girl. That was well deserved.
I mean, it was just like rubber wheels.
Plastic.
Oh.
Not like hard plastic, just...
Yeah, well, they were bolted onto like metal.
At least it wasn't an ice skate.
That nose would have been sliced clean off.
No, that's not how that works.
Much worse.
So much worse.
Man, I don't like you now, Jonathan. You're kind of a loser. Or loser is the wrong word, but he's like, he's not interesting the way he used to be.
Aren't you out of sight for sore eyes, huh?
Hi, Murray.
The kids like risotto?
Yeah.
Hey, dude.
It hits me. Didn't the buyers move here?
Small world, isn't it?
You're lying. There's no way the kids are gonna believe this.
You should just stay.
I'd be tempted, Joyce, except, you know, you have that,
Right, that business trip.
Business trip? What?
Yeah, you work from home. What kind of business trip are you gonna go on?
I have to go to a conference tomorrow in Alaska.
Alaska?
Yeah, that doesn't track, Joyce.
Smacked. Yeah, it was one of those vicious skate attacks.
A skate attack?
Yeah, but it wasn't like an ice skate. It was,
a roller skate?
Anyway, she looked like she's gonna be fine.
She's totally fine.
She didn't look fine.
Not now, dude. Not now.
Okay. I sense tension. The risotto, everyone. Nice. The risotto.
Absolutely.
Very perceptive of you, Murray. Am I supposed to know what house that is? Is that house supposed to be significant? Because I don't know. Oh, here we go. Vecna's about to reach out again. Oh, I remember those. Those like pinup calendars in like old gas stations and like garages and stuff.
What are you guys doing?
We're gearing up, preparing for the hunt.
Lynching, you mean?
And we're not killers like Eddie. And we just want to talk to him.
Yeah, sure, just want to talk to him. That's going to escalate, dude. It just is.
If you're not up to this, you can go home. There's no judgment. You'll still be one of us, all right?
Lucas.
I'm good.
Yeah, it might be really good that Lucas comes along, because he might be able to stop things from going too far.
Delivery service.
Eddie is slightly on edge.
And they're definitely looking for you. Also, they're pretty convinced you killed Chrissy.
Like 100% kind of convinced.
Yeah, it's kind of unfortunate.
Everyone and their shallow-minded mother is going to be gunning for you.
Hunt the freak, right?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly that.
Happens, we need to find Vecna, kill him, and prove your innocence. That's all.
How the heck are you gonna do that, though? That's just not gonna happen.
We've actually been through this kind of thing before. I mean...
Yeah, but prove innocence. Like, how are you gonna be able to do that? Like,
Like, here's the monster. Like, how Vecna doesn't come out into the normal world?
I see, we usually rely on this girl who has superpowers, but those went bye-bye, so...
There's nothing to worry about.
I think there is something to worry about. You don't have your... Yeah. Like the episode title, Superhero. All right. This poor guy.
No, there was nobody there. Nobody. And I already told this...
Like, how does this look?
Did you look into Victor Creel?
How does this look? Like, because they were investigating, like, looking for Eddie, basically. And then this guy ends up dead.
Miss Wheeler. It was by the picnic table, is that correct?
Hey, guys. This is a good team up. She should join them and try to get to the bottom of this. Back to the awkwardness in California.
Hop's cabin, right?
Yeah. This poor girl's been through so much in her life. Her short life so far.
You just don't really understand. Why didn't you tell me what's going on here? I mean,
I do wonder.
I'm not exactly
about that as well.
I am different.
Everyone is different.
I do not belong.
You mean in Lenora?
I mean, you have people you belong with. Mike, Will, and Dustin, and those people. Like your gang, you know?
Everyone looks at me like I'm a monster.
Well, they just don't know you.
Yeah, but you're a cool monster. Just because you're not normal, that doesn't mean it's bad. It means you're unique.
I care for you so much.
You don't love me anymore?
Who said that I didn't?
You never say it.
I say it.
Now you're in a pickle. Now you're in a bind, because if you say it now, it's just going to be like, because you had to say it.
From Mike.
They're nobodies. And you're a superhero.
Yeah, you are. You shouldn't have to be, though.
Hi, is Jane Hopper live here?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
What is this
song? Jane's father or mother around?
No, oh. No, her.
This is concerning.
You Jane Hopper?
Oh, what are we gonna do now? We can't go on the run. No, okay, she's being arrested.
11, listen to me, okay? 11.
She's going back into captivity.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Does she feel like maybe this is what she deserves or where she needs to be? Because, like, this is where she belongs, you know? Like, back at the lab.
Do you think I should have just told them?
No, you can't tell them. You can't get Eleven's hopes up.
Your children, they like to get involved. This way, what? They munch junk food, smoke some ganja, pound some beers, experiment sexually? I mean, really, what's the worst that can happen?
I think you listed all of them. But there is one more. Get in trouble with the law. By the way, I left my blind. Left this thing open. It's murderously hot in here, and I needed to cool down a little. I wouldn't have mentioned it, except that it's dawning. Expanding railroad, are we? Yeah, it's rough work. Ha! He's learning some Russian.
Urod!
Yes, urod!
Your Russian is getting better.
Yeah, it really is.
If my pilot gets the money, he will bring it to me in his plane tomorrow. Then you can hitch a ride with him back to your country. Sound too good to be true, yes?
Yeah, it kind of does.
Заканчивай с этим америкосом, он на рельсах.
Сейчас, я просто хотел пристранить его.
This is concerning that you're being this close.
So you're saying that this thing that killed Fred and Chrissy, it's from the Upside Down?
This is your Fred.
Oh, they just abandoned Eddie? That's rude.
This is something different.
Yeah,
something
this
new.
Is...
Doesn't...
Exactly.
It's only a theory.
Well, it makes sense if you consider Eleven losing her powers.
I mean, why them?
That is true, though. That is true.
Maybe Fred and Chrissy saw this Vec man.
Vecna.
I don't know about you guys, but if I saw some freaky wizard monster, I would...
Yeah, the victims and the places... we need more info. Like, we need kind of need more victims, actually, to be able to piece together stuff.
Something you maybe want to share with the rest of us?
I don't want to waste your time. It's a real shot in the dark.
Yeah, okay. Are you out of your mind?
Who are you going to go?
Need someone to...
Oh, big man.
I don't have a license.
Why don't you have a license?
I'm poor. I can drive.
No, no. Never again. Please, anybody but you, no.
So, Dustin?
No chance.
Wipe your feet. On the outside, not the inside. Always the babysitter. Always the goddamn babysitter.
Yeah, that's your lot in life. But you're really, really good at it. Is some of these flying creatures gonna make it through or something? Like, it feels like we need more monsters than just the Vecna. Because Vecna's not a presence we can fight.
Set me alone! I can't say no.
Yeah, of course you can say no. It's like Vecna is targeting people who are being bullied, or like people who are victims.
Lucas? What are you doing with these douchebags?
He's one of them now, unfortunately.
They try to recruit me to their club, cult.
Lucas, what the hell?
Yeah, you're throwing them under the bus hard, dude. It's not okay.
Not here.
Hey, man!
Yeah, just want to talk to Eddie. That's all, we just want to talk. You're gonna have to stand up to these bullies, Lucas.
I'm gonna need you to give me a verbal response.
Don't talk to the...
Yes.
Don't talk to the law without a lawyer. It's America, after all.
She doesn't seem that upset about it, does she?
No, she doesn't.
No, she doesn't.
Well, it was well deserved.
It means they're putting her in the system, after which point she'll be transferred to juvenile hall.
What?
Jail. You're gonna put her in jail. A detention hall for juveniles.
Yeah, it's gonna be great for her. And being put in the system, that's also not going to be great. Because they should have her prints from the lab, right?
It's such bullshit. I mean, she wasn't even trying to help.
Then what do we do?
I like this Jonathan.
We have to wait for Mom to
leave. It's like Jonathan's back, you know? Follow it. Follow it and then jailbreak. Come on, guy. Guys. We can do this. I believe in us.
Okay.
Hmm.
Yeah. Dumb biog.
Trying to get rid of the chains or what? Because this can't be part of the plan, right? I don't wanna. Ooh, dear lord. That's gotta hurt. Why are you doing this? I don't think you need to do this.
Means these murders predate 11 and the Upside Down by about 30 years?
Yeah.
Well, time might be working differently.
Something super solid up your sleeve that you were gonna wow us with later. But this is like really, truly a shot in the dark. Like, we
don't be so negative. She's the one who's supposed to be. I mean, she's Nancy, so if there's anyone who's gonna be negative, it should be Nancy, right?
Have fun.
Yep. We'll try.
Maybe Nancy can help you get better at socializing with women, Robin.
Do you have a minute to talk?
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah, this might work.
Are you implying that I still have a thing for Nance?
No, I'm not implying. I'm stating. And as it relates to your steadfast refusal to date Robin, it's pretty much the only logical idea.
No, there's another logical. Robin is not interested in men.
You're like bright red in the face right now.
No, I'm not. I don't want to talk about it. I'll punch you so hard in your face that your teeth will fall back out.
Oh.
Yeah, that was a bit far. But it was kind of funny. That's the thing with friends. You can go too far and still be okay.
Do you think you're ready to talk more about that night?
I don't think she is, no. Because who would ever believe her?
Did they talk to you? I mean, I know you were seeing Chrissy.
Max, you know I can't talk about Chrissy or any other student.
Then why are we even here?
Can I use the bathroom?
Sure. Up the stairs, to the left.
Thanks.
Gonna go looking for files. Hey, nice. Wipe the keys. Let's get to school in a hurry.
What'd she say?
Nothing, but just drive.
Nothing.
Steve, drive!
Okay.
He really gunned it. Nice.
Where the hell have you been?
Just listen.
Are you guys looking for Eddie?
Yeah, we found him, no thanks to you.
You found him?
He's at a boathouse.
No, don't tell him.
Sinclair!
Maybe, like, what I'm concerned about here is that Lucas will give up Eddie now to protect Dustin and the rest.
I know where Eddie's hiding.
Because if, yeah, maybe Vecna will intervene at the boathouse, and then it'll be two on two, like Lucas and Eddie, against these jock jerks. I don't get it. Why do jocks always have to be such jerks in like shows? Yeah. I was concerned about this because she was being put in the system. And there he is. So he did decide to come along, huh?
Come on, we're here.
Huh? That's nice. Murray managed to sleep the entire way. It's very convenient. Now he's well rested. That's not good that it was open. There's gonna be money missing. You're not gonna have enough to pay the pilot. Someone stole shit from you. Are you walking on a broken foot, Hopper? It's the idea that you're gonna slip out of your cuffs while no one notices your ankle cuffs? Oh, the self-control. The fact that he's just standing out. Well, I don't know how much damage was done to him in actuality. But like, shouldn't his like ankle be kind of dust? It's very uncomfortable, unpleasant. No. See, unlike the Vecna kills, the two people that Vecna has killed, this makes me cringe because this I can really relate to. This I know what it, this like. I can feel this. The other stuff that's just like so out of the realm of like possibility for me to conceive of like what that feels like. But that I very much can feel. Just gives me gives me the shivers.
Weekly Watcher, I can't believe they have this. Don't they write about like Bigfoot and UFOs? First of all,
now this is interesting.
We are looking for information on dark wizards. If someone's gonna write about that, it's gonna be these weirdos.
Yeah. It's not gonna be called Vecna though, because that's a Dungeons and Dragons thing.
Victor Creel claims vengeful demon killed family.
You're just making that up.
That shocked a small community.
You're not actually reading that.
Very funny. I'm not kidding.
Really?
Victor believed his house was haunted by an ancient...
Yeah, that's the house. That's the house from the Upside Down.
What if a demon did invade Victor's home?
Yeah, I mean, we...
This demon...
We know that this is the case.
It was Vecna.
Dustin, do you copy?
Yeah, I copy.
But why resurface now? And why did Vecna target Victor Creel's family? You know? Like, what's the purpose? What's the...
Get your ass over here! Stat!
We'll explain everything.
I thought they were talking to Miss Kelly. We leave them alone for 2 hours.
Yes, and then they're breaking into the school. Now don't go browsing, guys. Just get what you're here to get and get out.
Mini Watergate or something.
Although, you kind of shouldn't. Because Vecna targets, like, bullied kids or bullied people.
Fred was seeing Miss Kelly too.
So we might find, like, future targets if we, like, get all the files.
We move through the woods here together. And Patrick and Andy, you split up. Go around this way.
It's good that they're splitting up. That means Vecna can get the black guy, the guy who's, yeah, Vecna started targeting. It's good. It's going to be 2-on-2. Because there's no way. Like, if Lucas lets this happen, then he's done, you know?
I didn't mean to scare you, but you got yourself into quite a little predicament, didn't you?
She did, yeah.
We located you guys to Lenora because I thought, you know, safe town, small, dull.
Oh, he knew.
Far from Hawkins, nothing could happen here.
I don't remember season 3. There's a lot of it I don't remember.
Am I in trouble?
For the roller skate thing? No. We'll make that go away. Don't even worry about that.
It's good. And is he going to trust her when she says that she doesn't have her powers anymore?
I don't know how to say this other than just to say it. Hawkins is in danger.
Oh? Is Vecna why the lab is in Hawkins in the first place?
A war is coming to Hawkins.
That sounds serious.
Where you at, freak?
Oh no, I see. Lucas sent them to Hopper's cabin. I'm proud of you, Lucas. I thought for sure you sold Eddie out.
But they alone can't win this war. Not without you.
You got...
I know it's...
Nice, you got the ankle chains off.
You were the only one who might have a shot to hit this thing so hard it can't get back up.
Well, she can't. She doesn't have any powers anymore.
What if I told you there was a way to bring them back?
Yeah, I guess.
I've been preparing, developing a means to restore your abilities. A program that has the potential to not just...
That's a fancy laptop for the 80s.
...who think you are the cause. I believe they're wrong. I believe you're the cure. And that's why if we're really...
Okay.
My friends in Hawkins, are they in danger?
For sure they are, yeah. There's a lot of dangerous things there.
Go to them now. But if you do, you will risk everything. Risk everyone.
Oh no, Max is also gonna be a target. Oh, that's bad. And this has been going on for quite some time.
And it's okay to not be okay.
Max? What is it?
Max!
This is very intriguing. Oh no.
What if I'm not good? What if I'm the monster?
I don't know you that well, kiddo, but...
Interesting question.
Find out for yourself.
Of course she's gonna say yes. They're not even there. What about her waffles? Don't waste food. We're gonna transport these people back to Hawkins so everyone can unite. You dreaming, Max? Please be dreaming. Where's the clock? Fred saw the clock too. Right, or did he? I know for sure Chrissy did. This is bad news, guys. Bad news. Don't go toward the scary clock, grandfather clock coming out of the wall. I really hope she's not gonna be an idiot and keep quiet about this. I really hope that. Yeah. Hey, dude. Okay, so that was episode 3 of season 4 of Stranger Things. Very intriguing. I'm wondering if I have my window too open. Whatever. I really need some air in here. I really need this to cool down because it's so hot. I know I'm just in southern Sweden. It's not that hot like compared to most places in the world. But I don't like the heat. I very much do not like the heat. And in standard European fashion, we don't really have ACs here. You know, that's a very American thing. Anyways, this was an excellent episode, I thought. I really enjoyed this. Let's see, is there some easy stuff we can get out of the way before we get to the real discussion? I'm very lost on why Hopper felt the need to, like, crush his foot so that he could get the shackles off. And then he was, like, doing push-ups as if, like, he's preparing. Why would he be, like, he could do push-ups with the chains on, you know? Like, what? I don't get it. I don't get that part. Joyce, she must have money missing from her bag, right? There's no way all is left. So there's going to be like a conflict or a confrontation. Like there's going to be some issue with the pilot because she doesn't have enough money because some of it is missing. I didn't remember much of what the, or I don't, still don't remember much of what the doctor guy, Paul Reiser, what his role was in the previous season, but he's obviously a good guy. He helped out at some point, apparently. I think that's the easy stuff. 11. Like, it's the thing I want to talk about is, like, 11 and Vecna and, like, everything just, like, in one big messy pile. Because here's, like, my... The little brainwave I had there in the, like, beginning of the episode. It would make sense if this resurfaced because, like, 11 lost her powers. That might still be the case. But, like, I don't think it's a possibility that this Vecna is the source of Eleven's powers. I don't think that's a possibility, right? Because if that's the case, then... Like, it would be like some sort of basically like a possession. Like Vecna working through Eleven, but Eleven had control. So, Eleven harnessing Vecna in some way to do the things that she did. But it took a strain on her, that's why she bled from her eyes when she was doing it. Like, they're connected, they must be connected somehow. But if Eleven gets her powers back, then like using Vecna's powers to fight Vecna? And if Vecna is like inhabiting or like possessing or like being part of Eleven in some way in order for Eleven to exercise Vecna's powers, then how are you going to fight Vecna, you know? Might be a case, something along the lines of Eleven sacrificing herself while holding on tightly to Vecna and like taking out them both of them at the same time, like that kind of sacrifice. That's why I like, because the episode title is the Monster and the Superhero, and Eleven is concerned whether she is the monster and the superhero, and maybe she is both, you know? It just feels like that could be a thing. But at the same time, like, how can it? How can Eleven fight Vecna if she is Vecna at the same time, kinda? Although she's not really Vecna, but she's using Vecna. I like, it's complicated. Because this Vecna thing was obviously a thing back in the 50s as well for this Victor Creel. And what caused that whole incident with Victor and his family? Like, it's the house. We've that's definitely the house in the Upside Down that Vecna is inhabiting and using to reach out. Is that just a coincidence that it happened that Victor Creel and his family lived in the house that Vecna was inhabiting in the Upside Down? Like, what's the origin of Vecna? And what is Vecna's goal? Objective? Like, why is Vecna reaching out? Just for kicks? Just for fun? And why resurface now? Like, there must be something going on in the background. Like, there must be reasons for all of this. And I'm really curious about those reasons. We might not get into those reasons. This might just be a thing of like, yeah, Vecna's resurfaced and we need to fight Vecna. And like, that's all we think about it, maybe. I don't know. I'm proud of Lucas, by the way. I'm proud of him. I thought for sure that he would give up Eddie in order to protect Dustin or something along those lines. But he didn't. All in all, I have to say that this was a very enjoyable episode, and I'm really looking forward to seeing where this goes next. There's just something about this show that just gets me or something, or like, it just it just works for me so very, very well. I love basically everything about it. Just like, it's so striking visually. They've captured the aesthetic so well, and it's just like all around good performances as well from the, like, all the actors and so on. So what can we expect next? Max is in trouble. Max is in serious trouble. And this has been coming for a while. Right? Anyways, really looking forward to seeing what comes next. But that is for a different day. For today, I am done, and I thank you very much for joining me. I hope to see you in the next video, but until then, do take care of yourselves, and peace out.